This is NDTV. And you're watching NDTV Hindu.
Fishermen killed in mid-sea in the last 10 days. Top leaders condemn the attacks. But the Lankan authorities go on the defensive. The Lankan Navy says all allegations of killings are baseless. Amma lashes out at Karunanidhi for only sending telegrams, calling it a drama. Deceased fisherman Jay Kumar was an AIADMK member. This even as the finance minister talks tough on the gruesome killings. Pranab promises to take up the issue with Sri Lanka.
There is no point in justification for shooting at the people.
It's a fatal fall for this 16-year-old girl falling from a moving train. She sustained serious injuries. Asin says she respected Tamil sentiments to skip IFA but cannot take a call on where and when not to film in this exclusive chat.
We just comply by what the makers of the film ask us to do, as okay. In terms of, we have no say, especially a lead actress.
And 2020 is now the name of the cricket game. The glamorous format is now a stepping stone to the big league. Good evening, you're watching the news tonight with me, Divya. Let's also bring you the news making national headlines. BJP accuses the government of a disproportionate panic reaction in stopping its controversial flag hoisting march to Srinagar. Yediyurappa is in Delhi to formulate a political and legal strategy to counter corruption allegations against him. CPM refuses to support the CPI, which has backed off on the demand for a JPC on the 2G scam. The Bishnoi community shows black flags to Salman Khan during a marathon in Jaipur. India's top order collapses and Yusuf Pathan is still fighting to keep Indian hopes alive. More than 200 Indian fishermen have fallen to Sri Lankan bullets in the last 3 decades. That's our big story tonight. Another fisherman dead. And once again, fingers are being pointed towards the Sri Lankan Navy. Let me remind you now that this is the third attack on Indian fishermen in just this month and the second death in just 10 days. Well, last night's incident is one of the most gruesome killings ever reported. Jay Kumar, along with 3 other fishermen, were allegedly intercepted by the Sri Lankan Navy while they were fishing and were asked to jump into the sea. The deceased Jay Kumar had past horrors haunting him even as he was brutally murdered mid-sea. A tsunami survivor, Jay Kumar, perhaps frozen by the memories of that tsunami, was unable to move when he and other fishermen on the boat were asked to jump. Jay Kumar did not jump as instructed, and sources from the fisheries department say he was strangulated. A nylon rope was tied around his neck and he was dragged around by these men till he died.
Jay Kumar Sendile na Rajendra Munigan Dolgu Virna. Dolgu Virna Sanikala Night Padano Vermeji Valapati Varo. Silon Nagar on the Pudici. Tanila Paisananga, Tanila Panga, Jagama, Gentil Rajendra, Nalabangita, Jagama, Tanila Paila, Romana Paya, Nala, and Eganga Yaranjande, Yangapoto, Lakaita, Surkumati, Tanila Potilitur, Situ, Zirunde, Yvalan Kaito, Nurutanga, Adana Patibagala, பையனுக்கு உயிர் பிடிச்சி அதெல்லாம் நாங்கள் வலையை எடுத்துகிட்டு வரோம்.
Well, the Sri Lankan Navy is of course denying all allegations. They say that the allegations are baseless and without proof. This even as the Chief Minister has written to the centre asking them to punish the guilty and has announced rupees 5 lakh as compensation to the family of the victim. But is that enough? Listen to the Finance Minister promising action against those guilty of this terrible, terrible crime.
Essentially, in relation to the killing of Tamil Nadu fisherman by the Sri Lankan Navy, I am told that in the last 10 days, 2 persons have been killed. Naturally, Chief Minister is very much worried and anxious over these developments. We are having good relations with Sri Lanka. We are helping them, and there is no point and justification for shooting at the people. If they have done something wrong, they should have been arrested and handed over, as there is a due procedure of resolving these issues. So I assured the Chief Minister that I will take it up with through Foreign Ministry with the Sri Lankan authorities so that this is not being repeated.
NAIADMK Chief Jayalalitha has condemned what she calls unabated attacks on Indian fishermen. She says the attacks are continuing because the central government is not warning the Lankan government strictly. She has also slammed Chief Minister Karunanidhi for just sending telegrams and letters and calling it a drama. The deceased fisherman Jay Kumar, who died last night, is an AIADMK member. Well, if it's 2 fishermen killed in 10 days, then this is an even more shocking number. More than 200 fishermen have died in these murky waters just in the past few years. And NDTV Hindu has exclusive access to the first information report the FIR filed in 2008, clearly blaming the Sri Lankan Navy for the deaths of these fishermen. The visuals coming up on your screen is of that FIR that indicates the Lankan Navy as one of the accused in the killings. These fishermen belong to districts like Nagapattinam, Vedaranyam and Rameshwaram. Immediately after every incident, the state police has registered FIRs and murder charges against the Lankan Navy. But till date, no arrest or action has been taken. Fear and anger has of course gripped people after these killings. Today, 25 Tamil activists were arrested for protesting at the Congress headquarters in Satyamurthy Bhavan against the killing of these Indian fishermen. Activists are demanding for the immediate action to be taken to stop these killings.
தமிழக மீனவர்கள் சுடப்படும் பொழுது இவர்கள் எல்லாம் அமைதி காப்பது ஏன்? இதுவரை மத்திய அரசு கொடுத்த அந்த உறுதிக்கு என்ன அர்த்தம்?
And our question is that why this is repeatedly happening? A fisherman is doing a mistake, he can be prosecuted. But why he is being murdered?
Well, moving on to some other news, in a tragic accident, a 16-year-old girl sustained grievous injuries after she fell from a moving train. The young girl Sharon was travelling in the Hyderabad Express, and it was this morning when she fell down from the train when it was crossing Gummidipundi railway station. Her relatives raised an alarm screaming and pulled the emergency train to stop the train. The girl was rushed to Ponneri Government Hospital and she is currently undergoing treatment at a private hospital in Chennai. The chief ticket examiner has filed a complaint with the government railway police and investigations are underway. Now, what started as a routine health drive proved to be quite fateful for this family. It was the last day a 2-year-old boy slept on his mother's lap. This child died this morning 2 hours after he was administered with the polio drops. The postmortem is complete and the report is expected in 2 days. The infant's parents suspect that the polio vaccine given to their child this morning could be the cause, but the health secretary has denied these allegations to NDTV Hindu. He says it's not the polio vaccine, but it could be a possibility of aspiration after the child had eaten ice cream. Hence, the child's postmortem was videographed at the Krome Pitt General Hospital today.
Ice cream சாப்பிட்டா 9 மணிக்கு சாப்பிட்டா 9 மணிக்கு சும்மா ஒரே ஒரு டீஸ்பூன் தான் சாப்பிட்டான். அதுக்கப்புறம் எனக்கு தான் எல்லாத்தையும் எனக்கு உட்காந்து ஊட்டி விட்டுட்டு அவன் ஒரே ஒரு டீஸ்பூன் மட்டும் எப்பவுமே ஐஸ்கிரீம் விரும்பி சாப்பிட்றான். ரெகுலராக சாப்பிட்ற ஐஸ்கிரீம் தான், டெய்லி கூட சாப்பிட ஒன்றுமே ஆகாது, சளி கூட பிடிக்காது. எல்லாருமே அதை கேட்பாங்க, டெய்லி சாப்பிட்றான் ஐஸ்கிரீம் சளி கூட பிடிக்கலையேனு, அதனால சரின்னு ஐஸ்கிரீம் வாங்கி எனக்கு ஊட்டிட்டு இருந்தான். ஒரு வாய் சாப்பிட்டான் அளவுதான். அதுக்கப்புறம் விளையாடி ஐஸ்கிரீம் சாப்பிட்டு விளையாடிட்டு இருந்தான் மேலே மாடியில் 1 ஹவர் விளையாடிட்டு இருந்தான். கரெக்டாக 10:30 பால்னு கேட்டான். சரி பால் கொடுத்து தூக்க வருது, தலைக்கணெலாம் எடுத்து போட்டு கீழே பாய் போ அவனே பாயெல்லாம் எடுத்து தலைக்கணம் எடுத்து போட்டு தூக்க வருதுன்னா சரி தூங்குடா சொல்லிட்டு தூ பால் கொடுத்துட்டு புட்டி எடுத்து வச்சுட்டு கீழே வந்து துணி துவச்சுதான். அதுக்கப்புறம் எங்கள் அம்மா கத்தின போது தான் தெரியல, போய் பார்த்தேன் எப்படி செத்து போச்சு கிடக்குது.
And still ahead on the bulletin, is it a yatra to hoist a flag or is it the walk to gain those political brownie points? Find out when we come back.